Okay. Yeah, good afternoon, children. Yeah. Yeah, yeah. Okay. And all the teachers. Okay. Yeah. Welcome to our first KKC of the year. Yeah. And I'm so happy that you are able to make it, even it's raining heavily. So I think, together with the teachers, we should give them a big KKC cheer. The yay, yay, yay. All the teachers, let's thank them and cheer them. One, two.
Yay, 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 yay.
Yeah, good to see you all. Okay, is there, I think there are three new children. Three new children, where are they? Got three new children. They came for VBS. They came for VBS. Can you stand up?
The three Lim children.
The three
Lim
new children. Rain. Let's welcome them.
Lim Rain.
Yeah.
Lim Jack.
Okay, yay! Let's welcome them.
Wow, welcome.
Yeah. Okay, tell me your name.
Yakata.
Pardon?
Yakata.
Oh, this is okay, okay. This one?
Rocky, Rocky.
What's your name?
Lim Jack.
Lim Jack.
Lim Jack.
Lim Jack. Okay. Oh, Jack Lim. Okay.
Lim Wayne. Lim Wayne.
Oh, Lim Wayne. The other one?
Lim Rain.
Lim Rain.
Same name.
Rain, Rain.
Siblings, they're all siblings, okay. Lim Rain, okay, welcome, welcome. And I hope that you all will continue coming every week, okay? Let's have a short prayer before we go to praise and worship. Thank you, everybody. Hold your hands and close your eyes. Thank you, Lord, for a good year last year. And we pray for a better year this year. Amen. And we pray, Lord, that you will empower the children with good spirit and truth, and they will come to KKC faithfully every week. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Let's welcome our Auntie Yi and her team for praise and worship. Okay?
Okay, children, can you put down all your bags, all your gifts, put it on the chair, okay, and come forward and space yourself out in front. We are going to praise God together. Come. Come to the front. Okay, Ezra, stay. Okay, there. Okay, come, spread yourself out. Be careful of the camera stand. Huh? Okay, spread out. Not too close. Okay, get ready. Leave your brother alone. Don't hold on to it. Everybody free. Okay, see, do like this. Hey, hi, hi, hi. Like that. Ding, 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 ding. Make sure you don't touch any other person. Okay? Don't touch any other person. Spread out. Okay, children. It's so good that we can come, okay, to KKC at the beginning of this year. There are many new things that we want to do, okay, as God's special children. So are you ready? I want all of you to really praise God. You're not here to tengok wayang, menonton wayang, okay, auntie and the musician. Okay, we want to engage with God. Or involved with praising God. Okay, children, this morning or this afternoon, do you all eat your food? Why do you all eat your food? You need energy, Esther say. Okay, so remember, give her points on after, so teachers just identify. Esther say we need energy. But we need energy because all of us are living things. When you study science, what do you learn? You need food to grow. If not, you will be small. You will not grow. So today, our first song is about taking in, not food. Yes, we need food, but we also need the Word of God, the Bible. So the first song is, even we want to tell ourselves, this year we want to read God's Word. We want to pray. Okay? So are you ready? So I want everybody to sing along and do all the action. Okay, can or not? Okay, are you ready? Okay, let's start. Get ready. Ready? I see these children, the bigger one. Taku like that. Okay, I want everybody to do action. Can or not? Maxim can, read. How do you do Bible? Okay. Everybody, put your hands together. Bible. Read your Bible, you put your hands together like that. Open up like a book. Read your Bible. Pray. Pray. Pray every day. Then you are. Okay, Grow. Now, if I can do it, you can do it. Grow, grow, grow. Okay, Okay, everybody, let's do again. Better. Ready, go. Read your Bible, pray every day. Pray every day, pray every day. Read your Bible, pray every day. If you want to grow. It is God's love letter to us. One of the best message in the Bible is what Jesus did for us. Can you count? Let me see you show 1, 2, 3. So our next song starts with 1, 2, 3, and then God, 4 also God. Okay, let's see. Okay, let's pray. Let's thank God for what He did for us. Okay. One, two, three. Jesus is alive. One, two, three. Jesus is alive. He died for you and me. And on day 1. Jesus is alive. Jesus is alive. He died for you and me. But on day 3, Jesus rose again. Jesus is alive. God loved the world. What did he do? One, two, three, Jesus is alive. One, two, three, Jesus is alive. He died for you and me. But on day 3, Jesus rose again. Jesus is alive. One, two, three, Jesus is alive. One, on day 3, Jesus rose again. Jesus is alive. Jesus rose again. Jesus is alive. Okay, children, you just went back to school, right? Last week, Some of you got new friends. Some of you got new teachers. Am I correct? Yeah. But if you go for the first time, Sarawan, jangan takut. Remember, we learn. Okay, God is always with us. God is everywhere. Do you remember during VBS we learned? God is everywhere. And God loves you. He goes where you go. So today, even as we start KKC, we want to ask God, God, help us to live a new life. There are many things that we do that are not so good. So we want to throw away, sweep away. But we tell God, God, change our heart to be more like you. So our next song is Renew My Life. This is a prayer. So shall we all lift up our hands and make this your prayer? This is also your auntie's prayer. Okay, Okay. Get ready. Make this your prayer, children. No talking. It's between you and God, If you ask God, if you talk to God seriously, remember pray every day, Now we are praying to God seriously, okay? If you are serious with God, God will be serious with you, okay? This is a very beautiful song, asking God to change our hearts like His. Lift up your hands, okay? When we put up our hands, it is a sign of surrender. Let's lift up all our hands. We need God more and more each day. Law. yes, Lord. In my life and thought, there are so many things that needs the change that only your love can bring. And I need to be transformed into your likeness, oh Lord. Change this heart inside of me in my life. God, thank you for a new year. Thank you that you will go before us for this new year. We pray that even as we look to you, you will go and lead the way in our school, in our families, and wherever we go. We thank you. You love us so, so much. Help us to love you much more in return. In Jesus' name, we pray, and all God's children say, Amen. Amen. So children, slowly move back to your seats, but don't hit the camera leg, the stand. Huh? Okay. Thank you, children.
Okay, children, all seated. After the praise and worship, are you all refreshed? Yes. Yeah? Very refreshed for this new year. Okay? We are looking forward to this new year. A better year in everything. Okay? And more children coming for KKC. If your friends forget about it already, please remind them. Hey, KKC has started. You all must come back ready. Okay? Remind your friends who have forgotten. Huh? What am I holding in my hand? A box? Yes, good. Bible. How can it's a box? This is a Bible. Huh? It's a Bible. Okay? So, like you eat every day, you go to school every day, you do your homework every day. These are the things you do every day. So do you read the Bible every day? Do you? How many children read Bible every day? Put up your hands. Wow, very good. And those who don't, I think you should read it every day, like how you eat your food every day, you go to school every day. Make it a habit, a daily habit. Okay? Why? Why must we read the Bible? What is in the Bible? Inside the Bible is God's words. Okay? God's words, and they are all true, helping you in your daily lives, guiding you in your daily lives. So when you read the Bible, it will help you. There are many things inside there can help you in everything you do. And then what about prayer? Do you pray? Do you pray every day? Little children here, do you pray every day? Yeah. Prayer is also very important, because when you pray, you are having a closer relationship with God. You are building the relationship with God. When you're in problems, you pray. When you need to talk to God, you pray. That's where you are building the relationship and you're going closer and closer to God. Okay? Like just now, you sang the song, read your Bible and pray every day. Isn't it? Pray every day, pray every day. Read your Bible and pray every day. Pray every day, pray every day. Because if you read your Bible and pray every day, you will grow not only spiritually, but also physically. Okay, children? So that should be your daily habit and your daily routine. Like you can do things, other things, eating, even playing your computer games, you know. I see some of y'all non-stop, that one you cannot let go on. So that one you can do that. That means you can also read your Bible and pray every day. Okay? Let's pass the time to the Bible story? Peim, is it?
Okay, children, we will watch a Bible lesson now, okay? So focus,
God's story, the Bible. So part of God's story is about the Bible, and it goes like this. The Bible is no ordinary book. It's all about God and how much He loves us. Now, you might think the Bible's a big, long list of rules and names, but it's not. You might also think it's about a bunch of perfect people who always followed God's rules. But really, the Bible is a bunch of stories, poems, letters, and even songs that are all telling one big story that have been put together into one big book. And everything in the Bible is true, like how God created the whole world and everything in it. And the story is about Jesus, God's son. And in between, there are lots of stories written by all kinds of people. But the amazing thing about the Bible is all these stories came from God. The first part of the Bible is called the Old Testament. It tells the story of God's special family, the Israelites, and how God promised that through them, He would bless the whole world. To help them do that, God gave them the Torah, or the law. These were ways for the Israelites to live differently than other nations, by welcoming people who were different from them, forgiving each other, and following God. The only problem was, no one was able to follow all the rules. This is what the middle part of the Bible is about. People tried as hard as they could, but they kept making mistakes. And every time, God forgave them and promised them that someone would come, a king, a rescuer, who would actually follow all of God's rules and show us what God is like. Well, Israel waited a long time for the king, who was also the rescuer. While they were waiting, Israel had good kings and not so good kings. Sometimes the people in charge forgot about God and started to worship other gods. And sometimes they even got taken over by other countries. And whenever God would do something amazing, like when He saved three guys from a fiery furnace, or when He sent messages to prophets like Jeremiah and Ezekiel, or when ordinary people like Ruth decided to be a part of God's family, people would write it down. They wanted to remember what God had done and teach their kids what God was like. He's powerful, He's loving, and He's good. In some stories, God reminds us he's a good king, powerful and mighty, someone who saves his people from danger. In other stories, God reminds us he's a good father taking care of his children, or like a good shepherd, gently taking care of his sheep. Now that's all in the Old Testament. The next part, the New Testament, starts with four books full of stories about Jesus. Jesus is God's son, and he lived a perfect life without breaking any of God's rules. He taught people about God and showed people how to be like him by helping those who were poor and sick. Then, Jesus died for our wrong choices and came back to life, which was a pretty amazing thing. It was so amazing that people made sure they wrote down the stories about Jesus. And as more and more people started following Jesus, there were more and more amazing stories to write down. Like when the Holy Spirit came down like wind on Pentecost, or when people who followed Jesus performed miracles, or even when one of Jesus's friends, John, had a crazy dream about what it will be like when Jesus comes back to rule the entire world. After Jesus came back to life and then went to heaven, yeah, that happened. People who followed Jesus wanted to put together all these stories about the law, the Israelites, Jesus, and the early church into one big book. It took a few tries before everyone agreed on what parts should be in what order, but that's how we have this big book called the Bible. Today, people still read the Bible all over the world because what was true a long time ago is still true today. God always stays the same. God still speaks to us. He forgives us and loves us, and he's always good. And when we read the Bible, we can still learn about who God is and what he's like. The Bible says all scripture is inspired by God and is useful to teach us what is true and to make us realize what is wrong in our lives. It corrects us when we are wrong and teaches us to do what is right. And that's the story of the Bible. So in case you missed it, here's the quick version. The Bible is a book of stories about God. The Old Testament is about Israel. The New Testament is about Jesus and his followers. We can still learn about God today. And that's a part of God's story.
It's easy to read your favorite comic book, right? It's easy to read a hilarious bedtime book, right? But this doesn't look easy, does it? The Bible isn't the kind of book that you start at the beginning and go all the way to the end without stopping. That would take a very long time. The Bible is actually lots of books all smooshed together. Some of the books are stories, and other books are long lists of people. Some books are all about the promises God made, and then there are even more books of stories, like the story of Jesus when he was a baby, and the story of when Jesus died to take away our sin. When you put them all together, these books tell God's story, and it's all right here. So take your time and read one part at a time. It's even better when you read it with someone else and talk about what you learned. That's how you read the Bible.
Children, remember that God's word is a light unto my path. Okay? It's so important to have God's word. Do you see the darkness? Do you notice? Everywhere was dark. Only God's word is the light. So it shows you how important it is to have God's word. Okay? Okay. Look, I have quite well armored. Oh, I have my belt of truth, my breastplate of righteousness, my shield of faith. Let's go attack the enemy. Attack! You know why not, children? Why did I run? What's missing in my armor? Huh? I have only armor to protect myself. No, nothing to attack. What is the sword? Do you know what is the sword? Do you know what's the sword? Yes? Isaac, what's the sword? Yeah. The sword. You know what's the word of God called? Yes? Zoe, what's the word of God called? Yeah, it's called the Bible. The word of God is called the sword of the Spirit. The sword of the Holy Spirit. That means God can use God's word, the Bible, to fight. Hey, my enemy ran away. See? My enemy is so scared of me. I ran away already when my sword came. So, children, early in the year, we want you to learn that the Bible is very, very important. Right? The Holy Spirit can bring about the words that you have learned to fight who? Very good, Isaac. Fight our enemy. Who is our enemy? That's right. The evil one, Satan. Right? We cannot see one, no? He can be all over the place. That's why we need what? That's right. We need to know. It's no use buying a lot of Bibles and put in your house, you know? I have quite a number of Bibles all collecting dust. No use. You must open it and read it. Okay? And then I suggest you start with New Testament, okay? It's harder to start with the Old Testament. So I suggest you start from Matthew. Okay? And today we will be making a bookmark. I suggest, and I challenge you all, okay, to read the whole Bible slowly, okay? You can read one chapter at a time, one paragraph at a time, then you put your bookmark, okay? Matthew 1, okay? Today, very busy. Only read Matthew chapter 1, verse 1 to 5, let's say, okay? Then you put your bookmark there, okay? All of you will get a bookmark. You put it there, then next day, oh, you have a lot of time waiting for your friend. Your friend not Pangjo. Okay? So you read more. Wow. You managed to read many chapters. Oh, Matthew 5. Oh. So you put your bookmark there. Okay? Whenever you finish reading the Bible. Oh, by the way, before I did, anybody has read the whole Bible? Very good. Zoe, anybody else? Very good. Okay? Very good. That is not counted on. We want to start from Matthew, okay? You start from Matthew, you read, then you finish, you go to Old Testament. But you can jump, but harder to keep track, okay? I challenge you, you finish the whole Bible. Anytime you finish the whole Bible, you come to me, I will give you a prize. Okay? It shows you how important the word is. Okay? Keep it in your heart. Read it. The first important thing is you read it. If you know it, even better. Okay? Thank you.
Hi, children. Now it's memories time again. I want 10 boys and 10 girls. Auntie Ellen, can you choose 10 boys and 10 girls? 10. Auntie Ellen will choose, huh? Or maybe Auntie Mao Cheng also choose from this side, girl? Auntie Ellen choose the boy and Auntie Mao Cheng choose the girls. Ten boys and 10 girls. Come out. Okay, children, listen. Today, memory verse is very short only. I want you all in a group to discuss and arrange the memory verse. After you arrange, stand and put up the papers. Understand? Can understand, boy? Can? Among yourself to arrange the memory verse. I give you 2 minutes. Two more boys again. Okay. Arrange the memory verse among yourself. Arrange, and stand together. Arrange together. choose. Try to arrange it. If you can arrange. I give your time, no limit. Try to arrange it. According to the memory, was you try and choose, ask them to come out. Okay, are you ready? Okay, if you are ready, take up the papers. Take up the papers, show. Each of you take up your papers. Take up and show the memory verse. Paper. Take your paper up. Stand in a row. Okay. Take up your paper. Okay. Okay. Let's see the memory verse is correct or not. Huh? Okay. Children, can you read out from the screen? Children, read out from the screen. For the word of God is alive and powerful. Take up the paper. Please take up the paper. Please take up the paper. Take up the paper. Okay, children, let us read one more time. For the word of God is alive and powerful. Hebrews 4 verse 12. Okay. Boys, they arrange all very good and correct. And girl is, yes, correct also. It's all correct. Can you all read together one more time? Turn around and see the screen and read out one more time. Turn to the screen. All read together, everybody. 1, 2, 3. For the word of God is alive and powerful. Hebrews 4:12. Okay, children, shall we read one more time? For the word, I cannot see you, is alive and powerful. Hebrews 4:12. Okay, children, you may go back and sit down. Boy and girl also 100 points. They all do all correct. Sit down first, children. Collect your point and sit down. Sit down, children. Okay, children, sit down. Children. This memory verse mean, God's word is very powerful and alive. We are not only read it, we will apply it every day in our life. It will tell us in our life what we should do wrong and what is right. If we are applying for God's words, we pray every day, our lives will be easier. Children, can this side of children read again one more time? For the God is alive and powerful. Hebrews 4:12. Children, this side, can you read one more time? For the word of God is alive and powerful. Hebrews 4:12. Thank you, children.
kids, let's talk. Let's talk about talking. You love to, can you? You love to talk? We all love to talk so much. We talk to everybody, everywhere, every day. Some talk every minute, everything. But do you talk to God? Do you talk to God? Good. Jesus loves to talk to God. Let's watch.
Stories of the Bible. Jesus prays in Gethsemane. This is Jesus.
Heyo!
Who is the Son of God and the Savior of the world. While Jesus was on earth, he taught everyone about God's love and healed people from their sickness. He did many miracles like calming storms and even raised people from the dead.
Wahoo!
Jesus was in Jerusalem with his disciples for the Passover. Passover was a festival that the Jewish people had celebrated since the time of Moses, when God brought his people out of Egypt. Jesus knew the time had come for him to die, as the scriptures had said long ago. So he went with his disciples to an olive grove called Gethsemane. And Jesus said, "Sit here while I go to pray." He took Peter, James, and John with him, and he was very distressed and troubled. He asked them to stay with him and keep watch, meaning he wanted them to stay awake with him.
Got it.
He went a little farther on and prayed. He cried out, "Abba, Father, everything is possible for you. Please take this cup of suffering away from me. Yet I want your will to be done, not mine." Then an angel from heaven appeared and strengthened Jesus. Then Jesus prayed even harder and was suffering greatly. He went back to his disciples, and they were all asleep.
Hello?
He said to Peter, "Couldn't you watch with me even 1 hour? Keep watch and pray so that you will not give in to temptation." And then Jesus left them again to pray, the same as he did before. He went back to the disciples after he had prayed and found them sleeping again. The disciples didn't know what to say. So Jesus went away a third time, praying the same things again. When he went back to his disciples, he said, "Go ahead and sleep. But look, the time has come." For Judas, the disciple who was betraying Jesus, was coming with men to arrest Jesus. Judas showed them who Jesus was, and they arrested him. Jesus was taken and put to death on a cross to save us from our sins. But 3 days later, he rose from the grave.
Huh? Heyo!
He is alive. He stayed with his disciples for 40 days and then went to heaven.
See ya!
God then sent the Holy Spirit to be the helper as God's people go out and tell the good news of Jesus to all the people of the world.
What lessons can we learn from this Bible story? 1. Praying is talking to God. Jesus, in his darkest moments just before he was taken to the cross, he went to the Garden of Gethsemane to be alone with God, to talk to God, to pray. Jesus loves to talk to God. Jesus loves to pray. And Jesus reminded his disciples to pray. Jesus said to his disciples, watch and pray. Stay awake. Pray. Don't sleep now. It's time to pray. Jesus wanted his disciples to pray. Jesus wants us to pray. We like to talk to our friends, but sometimes our friends may be too busy to listen to us, to layang us, you know? But when we talk to God, God always listens to all that we pray. God always listens all the time. God listens to every word, every snow. Not snow, snore. That means when you pray and sleep, you snore. And God hears, don't snore, don't sleep, pray. God is happy when we talk to him. God smiles when we talk to him. 2, prayer brings us closer to God. Jesus prayed, Abba, meaning Daddy, Papa, Father. God and Jesus, their relationship is that of a father and son. We too have a father-son relationship with God. Abba, God is our beloved Abba, Father. So, let's open our lives to him. Let's open our hearts to him. So, let's pray. When we pray and ask God to lead us, to guide us, to help us, we are opening our lives to him. We are inviting him into our lives. We are inviting God to be part of our lives. When we pray and share our joys, our sorrows, our feelings, our thoughts, we are opening our hearts to him. So let's pray. Phone calls connect us to our friends. Prayer connects us to God. Parties, gatherings bring us closer to our friends. Prayer brings us closer to God. Football, netball, games build relationship with our friends. Prayer builds relationship with our God. So prayer is powerful. Prayer is a way, the way to connect us with God, to bring us closer to God, to get us closer to God, to build relationship with God. Children, we have a very precious relationship with God, a father-son relationship. So treasure this relationship, build this relationship, aim for a closer relationship with God. Connect with God. So let's learn to connect with God, to pray every day, to talk to God every day. In,
In conclusion, the power truth for today's Bible story, or this Bible story, is anybody can guess after hearing so much. Nobody? See already yourself. Anybody? Jane? What is the power truth of this Bible story? What do you learn from all the Auntie Eunice talk just now? Okay, never mind. Oi, sorry. Okay, never mind. The power truth of this Bible story is pray every day. Didn't you hear me just now say pray, 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 pray every day? Children, talk to God every day. Pray every day. Make God smile every day. Make Auntie Eunice smile every day. Okay, hope you are blessed. Remember, pray every day. Bye, see you.
Okay, children, there are only two key points today that we learned. 100 points, you can answer. Your daily habitual habits. Two. What is number one? Who can answer? Okay, Jenny? Okay, pray every day. The other one? Read your Bible every day. Very good. Reading your Bible every day and praying every day. This is the thing that we learned today. Two key points. Okay?